Hello and welcome to the Vector Garden YouTube channel. My name is Monika and in this video we're going to look at methods on how to analyze a pattern that doesn't work. So this artwork should be a pattern. Now I'm going to zoom out a little, and in order to do that I'm going to select it all. It has been prepared, so everything is there, even the invisible rectangle in the back. So I should just be able to take that and drag it into the swatches panel and then get a pattern. But that doesn't work. So obviously something in there prevents it from being made into a pattern. Now I can make assumptions on what that might be. And I know that patterns inside patterns don't work, but maybe I don't know anything about patterns, so this is my first pattern, and what could I do? Now, if I'm going to the other way to make a pattern, so I'm going to Object, Pattern, Make, then Illustrator will throw a pop-up with a warning to tell me, okay, patterns cannot contain anything painted with a pattern, so I'm sure there's a pattern in it. There's another method to find out what's in your artwork, and we're just going to look at it. You can go to Window, Document Info. And, well, this is not very helpful, but you can go into the menu and turn that to Objects, and then it will tell you everything about the selected art. This is also a setting, so you can go in here, and this is set to selection only, so it will tell you only about the selected artwork. And you can go down there and see what's in it, and there are compound paths and clipping masks and RGB objects. Of course, this is an RGB file. And then there are pattern objects and gradient objects and brushed objects. So these might cause issues, but in fact, Illustrator is just complaining about the patterns. Now, this is kind of complicated, so where are they? Now we know that patterns can be swatches. So let's go to the swatches panel. This is open already. And you can, in this menu, say, okay, I want only the pattern swatches in here. And there we see, okay, this is the pattern. It's a common error to have a solid fill turned into a pattern, but that's another case for another video. So it's here. Now, still, where are those artworks? Now, I could now try and find them. I could just select this, and this is now in the patterns, and I could go to select, same fill color, and obviously it's not a fill, so I could switch them so the pattern is now the stroke color, and then go to select, same stroke color, and Illustrator selects some of these elements. So what I can now go to is get this pattern to the front and then show all swatches, and there's no similar one, so let's go into this here and let's set it to black first and then go to RGB and make it a dark brown. You could also open that pattern and pick up the color from inside of there, so, but I'm just going to eyeball it. Now, okay, we have found all of them. So let's select that again and drag it in there again, and it fails. So what's up? Let's go to the document info again and let's turn that selection only off. And now we see there are again 7 more pattern objects. But where is it? So it's possible inside an Illustrator file that there are patterns which are not swatches. So how do we find these? Thankfully, there's Astute Graphics Find and Replace Art. So I'm going to go there, open their menu, and then go to Find Replace Art. This is a nice set of plugins, and this find and replace helps me to find the patterned object. So I'm going to search for paths and then search for the fill. Or we have seen that the other pattern was a stroke. So let's search for strokes, which have a pattern. It's already selected because I have used it previously. And then let's go to this button, and Find Replace Art will select all the objects that have a pattern as a stroke. And again, we can now go to the stroke menu, and let's set that to green first, and then let's pull up the sliders and set this to a nice gold looking color, like so. And now we can go to the document info again and check if there are some more, but no more patterns. So now we can select this all and then drag it inside the swatches. And there is our pattern. So let's just draw a rectangle and apply the pattern. So that's how you can find the issues with your file, thanks to plugins. If you liked the video, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. See you next time.